And then I'm gonna say hello and welcome to the Gamer Gents Duo podcast. Not a number. This is a special show that we are only doing E3 for this special occasion. The E3 pre-show Gamer Gents Duo podcast. We're recording this right now. It is 6/12/2015. So
Friday,
June 12th. Right? Yeah, on a Friday night before the eve of E3. So the plan is to have this go up Sunday morning because Bethesda kicks off E3 Sunday night.
You know, this reminds me. You know how every time we would record on Sunday, and then you'd be like, "There's a flash sale," and then wait, it's already over.
Yeah, it's already.
This would be a great time to do it, but now.
Yeah, now there's no flash sale. GG. What if they have an E3 flash sale? It's like pre-orders,
awesome.
Like $5 off or something.
Right.
That'd be crazy. So I'm one of your hosts, TBCAC, but you can call me Teddy. And I have along with me, as I do every week, Eric.
Eric, also known as LegendPVM on Twitter.
And, most other places, to be honest.
Yes, most PSN, everywhere.
What? Everywhere now. All right.
Everywhere.
This is definitely a different show. We only want this to go for like a very short period.
It's a little catch up.
Yeah, it's basically to prep you if you don't know too much about E3 to be like, this is how it's going down. This is what you can be on the lookout for. This is what we're excited for, and we're gonna go over our predictions.
And we can probably recommend some places to get coverage and seeing, yeah.
Heck yeah, basically just like how to follow E3, your little short guide. But I do want to go over our regular show stuff, which is like what we're playing and the news, but we're going to do that for literally like 5 minutes. And then we're going to do freaking lightning round. So we're not going to be like I normally do, I played something on Monday, but I can't remember, because that's how it usually is. I was playing Elder Scrolls Online, Destiny, on the PS4. Freaking great. I just want to play
it's
that.
It's great.
More.
It is really great.
Every time I get on and Eric's not playing, I'm like, what is Eric doing with his life right now? This is so good.
Talking to women.
it's
true, though.
Dang, bro.
Priorities.
It's like name dropping up in here. Just freaking calling yourself a baller.
Although, I would be definitely playing. I think it was like yesterday. I was like, okay, I'm gonna get home. I'm gonna play some ESO all day, and then maybe team up with Teddy and do some dungeons and stuff. And then I don't know. I sat at my computer and messaged a girl all day. So, it just happens.
Gee.
I don't know.
This is the master plan of all females.
Hey,
take over males gaming life.
You.
No, I understand. I used to text my girlfriend during League of Legends. That was awful.
That's impossible.
Now, looking back at that, I was like, how did I even do that?
that's like kind of like your thing with like eating.
Yeah,
like
I was.
Games.
Yeah, I don't know how I don't actually understand how I did that. Looking back, I'm like, I don't.
When you're dead, you're dead for a long time. But anyway,
yeah, later in the game, you are dead for a while. Like if it's way late into the game and
you
die,
you're like
40 you're like
seconds,
a minute and a half. I've gotten to that before, where you're dead for like a minute and a half.
It's horrible.
It's super long. Well, if that happens, the game's over.
Yeah,
they make a deciding movement where when you're dead for a minute and a half, and the rest of your team
it's
is
when
dead
you
for
surrender.
A minute and a half, it's like, all
right,
we're done here.
All right. You've been playing Destiny, ESO.
Yeah. Nothing else really. That's it.
Yeah.
Minecraft. I watch this guy, I Jenner. He's a friend of mine. I'm a mod in his Twitch channel, and he basically plays Call of Duty Zombies. And I keep watching him, and I'm like, because I used to be super into Call of Duty Zombies, but I'm watching this, and I'm like, man, I don't know like any of these maps, because he plays like Black Ops 2 Zombies. And I'm like, I really want to. I don't know. I want to play this. So I'm going to sit down and play Origins sometime soon.
Well, yeah, you're going to get a better computer.
Yeah, I'm going to get a better computer. I'm all be streaming in PC. You got Eric's creepy face over there. That was great. But yeah, so also, this is one of the pieces of news that we're going to get to in a minute. Steam Summer Sale is happening right now. So I was thinking of buying Black Ops 1 and all the DLC. It's still pretty expensive, but like, Those were my jam. Like, I know all that. I know how to work Ascension. I could get to round 60 in Ascension if I wanted to.
You just remind me there's a Steam sale, and I just got my first paycheck. I'm screwed.
Rip in peace. So, holy crap. So what have you been playing?
I haven't been playing Destiny.
You played one match literally just now.
One match before this podcast.
Just now.
And I didn't win, but I love Destiny PvP. People say it's overpowered. People who are not as experienced or don't have the best guns, obviously, they won't have the most fun with it. But like, it's so solid. Like, when you have a good connection, when you do have a good connection, kills are just, it's fun. Kills are accomplishing.
It's fun when you do well. But yeah. I don't know why. I legitimately feel like in that game, when I do bad, I feel it in my soul more than in any other game. Yes. Like, more than in any other game. It just hurts. I'm like, I don't know why.
It's probably because you put so much time into it and then feel like you're doing bad at something.
And it's because, like, in that game specifically, in most games, I can be like, all right, this is the problem or whatever. Whenever I do bad, I don't know why.
See, I can't figure it out. My only solution to that, honestly, is like,
just stop.
Go a different way, do a different method of doing the same thing. Yeah. I don't know.
Yeah. So you're playing Destiny, you played ESO a little bit.
Yep.
You're playing that Agario.
Agario, yeah, that was more last week. But yeah, Agario is a fun, relaxing. When you're watching a YouTube video, over here.
Whenever I was streaming and I went to log into ESO and it gave me the queue, I would just pull up Agario and play that for like 5 minutes. I didn't, at one point it let me in. I was like, I don't want to leave. I'm actually doing well for once.
Right.
But
yeah, outside of that, I mean, I played a little Fallout. I've abandoned Witcher 3. It's not going to be a freaking Dragon Age Inquisition. I'm not letting it do that. Be like that.
What was Dragon Age Inquisition?
I played like 10 minutes of it and never played it again. I mean, I enjoyed it.
I've already played The Witcher for like 15 hours or so, yeah, so same. I'm already like fine. But yeah, I have no hopes.
I have not gotten my money's worth out of Witcher yet, but I will because I'm not gonna like put it on the backlog. It is in the front log. So, I just made a word up, but anyway. That's pretty much it. Fallout, Destiny, ESO. I've been playing a lot of ESO before it even came out on PS4. So, yeah, that's.
The news, real quick. Literally, I'm gonna go through these like bullet points. There was a surprising amount of news. Like on a normal week, we could talk about this for an hour, but like, I gotta go over this in like 2 seconds. Mega Man Legacy Collection announced by Capcom, which is, I think, 1 through 8, and then...
Can I pre-order that on PS4?
I don't think so. Not yet, at least. I
want that.
No, it's the first 6 Mega Man games, and it should be for current gen.
I've heard 7 and 8 aren't that great.
Yeah. So there you go. Mega Man Legacy Collection. Pretty cool. Oculus Rift. Lots of stuff. They had a conference. Basically... Which is weird that they had it, like, before E3. They basically, you know, the key points was, like, they showed off a lot of games for it.
Yeah.
Which is new because everyone else is like, oh, it's cool, but how does it work with games? So they showed off a lot of games, and they were like, this is what's coming. They also said a release date, but let me find it real quick. Let's see. It gets a price, a release date, all sorts of stuff. So let me find this. The release date is Q1 of 2016, which is the same as Project Morpheus, going head-to-head. This article said price, but I didn't know about that, so I want to see that. Oh, no, there's no price here. Oh, wait. No.
Go ahead. Just saying, Metro 2033 pack and Metro Last Light pack is, like, they're, like, under $10, so. That if anyone ridiculous. Likes Metro games, there you go. On Steam. Yep.
Okay. So yeah, Oculus Rift. They also announced that it comes with a wireless Xbox 360 controller, which is a little odd, but you know, it's whatever. And then they also showed off these like touch things that are like sensitive to your hands that you like. There's something, but yeah. Oculus Rift is going to be interesting. Definitely going to be interesting VR stuff. You're going to see a ton more about that at E3.
Right.
Steam Summer Sale. It's happening right now. Let me see if I can find.
I'm looking through it right now.
I need to find the
I know what I'm purchasing.
The end date. I'm legitimately thinking of just getting Black Ops and all the zombie maps.
21st. That crap. 11 through
21st. Oh, 21st. Yeah. Dang, son. That's until next Sunday. You have exactly a week when you were listening to this right now.
Yeah. Good thing I got a job before.
GG. Dungeon Defenders 2 has been confirmed to be coming to PS4 this year.
Sweet.
Which is awesome. That's basically amazing. As I was scrolling through the news, I just saw this, that were like, the developers are like, yeah, it's on its way. It's That's almost awesome. There. It's coming this year.
Really because, hope they have refined it to
the Yeah, point. it's on early access on Steam right now.
Oh, yeah. I'm patient.
Yeah. No, I don't wanna play it on early access. Yeah. I'm like excited to see what that final product looks like, you know. Right. The Punisher
is gonna be
cast in Daredevil season 2.
As Shane.
Shane from The Walking Dead. The actor, I don't actually have his name and I apologize. But the guy who played Shane from The Walking Dead is going to be the Punisher in season 2 of Daredevil, which I think is awesome casting. That's really cool. I'm excited for that. Definitely excited for that.
John Bernthal,
congratulations. Golf clap.
You're in a good show.
A great show.
You get lots of freaking money.
Rolling in that cash.
Right. Netflix cash.
Netflix cash. So, Super Meat Boy is coming out for PlayStation. PlayStation 4 and Vita, finally. And
just the game itself?
Guess what? It's going to be free for PlayStation Plus members.
Well, dang.
So there you go. So pretty much anyone who has a brain, it's free for. Oh, bam! No, I'm just kidding. this is actually a serious one, which is kind of sad. Christopher Lee, the actor who played Saruman and Count Dooku, died at the age of 93. But to be honest, I wasn't that sad about this because it says at the age of 93. He lived a good life, all right? And it was, I'm pretty sure it was just of, like, old age. You know?
No, it was heart problems.
That's mostly old age, but you know what I mean. Like, I don't know. I wish he had, did he die, like, in his sleep, or was it, like, an actual heart attack? Yeah, if he died in his sleep of, like, heart problems, that's kind of, like, old age, and that's a good way to go. So,
I'll look at it.
Yeah, dude, it's sad, but 93.
Yeah.
it's sad, but
Heart failure, and he was in the hospital, I believe.
Oh, okay. No,
I mean,
that's a bummer.
Not as
peacefully, but
yeah. But I mean, he's a great actor, and I mean,
yeah. So yeah,
he's a cool dude. It seems, and I don't know.
So,
all these celebrities that are real, like, or actors who are actually like real good people are dying, and it's kind of sad.
Yeah. So, Eric, tell me some of these Halo 5 details real quick. Oh my gosh, you almost just ripped that.
Oh my gosh, I don't know where to start. Did you watch any of the things I sent you?
I watched one of them.
It's in. There is so much going on.
I know there's a lot, and I know it's awesome, but
I can summarize it in a few words here. It's nothing that we've seen in a Halo game. There will be two teams that you'll be playing in the campaign, I'm assuming. You'll have Team Blue, which is consisted of, I can't remember the names, but Master Chief is the head, and then Team Osiris.
I think I actually know the name of Team Blue.
Oh, the names?
Yeah, one of them's Fred.
Wait,
is Fred on the other? No, yeah, this is it. Fred, Linda, and Kelly.
Linda and Kelly. Yeah, and they But here's a cool thing is that you can switch between each character on a whim.
And they all have different like loadouts.
But they usually have a pistol as a backup, obviously. So, like, but G&G. I mean, one has an SMG, one has a sniper rifle, one has an assault rifle, and a DMR.
Yeah, I really want an Xbox One.
If anyone's confused with a DMR, it's pretty much a scout rifle like in Destiny. But yeah. And it's the same thing on the Team Osiris, but Locke is the leader, Sergeant Locke, and he is sent by Oni to not kill Chief, but to...
Yeah, I thought it was interesting.
...strain him or something.
They said bring him back.
Bring him back. Everyone thought it was like to kill him because of that teaser with the bullet going through Chief's...
You never know. Maybe that's what it comes to. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, maybe Locke will be forced to start to try to kill him, but you'll be playing both characters. All eight characters if you want to.
That's crazy.
And apparently if you want to do co-op, it's drop in, drop out, like the Lego games.
Because awesome. Yeah, because the character is always there anyways, take control.
And also you can send your
You can like issue commands.
Your comrades to do things. If you see like a stationary turret, hey, go over there. Or you see a big enemy, like a hunter, and you're like, oh, hey, kill that, focus on that, and you can like sneak around and kill it or something. But yeah.
Awesome.
It's really new for a Halo game, and it fits it. And apparently, which something I heard really interesting, the YouTubers who were able to play the Halo 5 mission, it was the second mission, and they have that literally to just warm you up to the game and the new features like the command system. That mission is like very linear.
Yeah.
But hearing that is really interesting because that means I'm guessing all the other missions in the game will be kind of pick and choose how you want to do things, kind of like a Splinter Cell game or a Metal Gear Solid game, where you can plan stuff out and which is interesting for a Halo game. So.
Yeah, I don't know. I just really want an Xbox One because I want to play the Master Chief Collection, and then I want to play this because this sounds awesome. So maybe one day.
Well, go ahead. If you want to, like, when we have, like, time, me and you should, like, at the same time, like, save up for a Xbox One and just get it.
It's not gonna be like, it might not be simultaneous, but, like, if I ever just have the money, it's gonna happen, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, I don't know. Ratchet and Clank for the PS4 was announced and is coming out along, and
it's up for pre-order right now.
Yeah, $40, which is great. I love when developers establish, like a lot of... No game is, like, $40, and people are like, why? There are so many games that feel like they would be great in the $40 price point, and Everyone's just like, it's either 60 or, like, 15 or 20, you know? And no one, like, goes to that middle ground.
$40 is a really good area.
Yeah, no one goes to that middle ground, so I was, like, excited to see that. That's really cool. And I would gladly pay 60 for this for what I saw from the trailer because, holy crap, it looks really cool.
Yeah, it looks awesome.
And it's a reboot, as in restart of the Ratchet & Clank franchise. They're basing it off of the PlayStation 2 game, but they are restarting, and it's going to be coming out alongside the movie. So
now we just need the Jack and Daxter game.
Never gonna happen, mate. Sadly.
Please.
All right. So, on to the actual E3 stuff. E3. It's happening. It's Sunday when you're listening to this, if you're listening to this as soon as it goes live. It is Sunday. Bethesda is kicking off E3 on Sunday night. So let's just go over and go through the conferences. I'm going to transfer this. Oh, no. I don't need to, actually. It's already in my... Okay. Yeah. So here are all the conferences. Sunday night is Bethesda at 10 o'clock Eastern, which is Eric's time.
Yes.
And, not, which is 9 o'clock me.
I don't work. Yeah. I don't work Sunday or Monday.
Oh, I totally work Monday, but I don't care. Like, dude, I bet like, you money I'm going to work Monday. I looked at my schedule,
and I knew E3 was on, like, these days, and yeah. I knew Bethesda was on Sunday. I have both of those days off.
Yeah,
it's so good.
I don't have Monday. Oh, you have Monday off? Gosh.
Mm-hmm. Sunday and Monday.
Well, I don't because I have the college thing from on the 17th and 18th, and then I'm leaving on the 20th, and blah, blah, blah. So,
I work all day tomorrow, so that's probably why I'm off two days. So.
Well, I mean, I work all day tomorrow. Oh, well. Bigger paycheck. Oh, All right.
So Bethesda, 10 p.m. Eastern, 12 p.m. AET, whatever the heck that is. and 6:30. Oh, that's the IGN pre-show. Never mind. what's the other times? PT, 7, ET 7 p.m. Like Pacific time. California. There you go. Yeah. We got to tell everyone.
Yeah.
So...
Microsoft kicks off the next day. Microsoft always, this is the way it goes. Microsoft starts on Monday and then Sony,
and then concludes. Sony comes in with a big
one. Gosh dang, dude.
That one E3 though.
That's the only E3 that I actually got to watch live ever, other than this year. So, and it was the freaking console launch E3. Oh, so it was the best. So that was like my favorite thing ever. That's like one of my favorite
PS4 was memories. Just like Sony was just like wrecking it there.
So Microsoft is kicking it off at 12:30 p.m. for Eric, which is Eastern, which is 11:30 for me. And then EA goes at 4 p.m. Eastern and 3 for Central and 1 for PT. And Ubisoft then goes at 6 for Eastern, 5 for Central, and 3 for PT. And then Sony finishes at 9 Eastern, 8 Central, and 6 PT. And then the next day, and then on Tuesday, Nintendo has their Nintendo Direct, which isn't ever a conference. They send in like a video, and that airs at 12 Eastern, 11 Central, and 9 a.m. And then Square Enix has their conference at 1 Eastern and 12 Central and 10 a.m. PT. And then the PC Gaming Show, which is one of the newer conferences this year.
Is that hosted by PC Gamer or something?
What is, like, PC Gamer, like, the magazine thing?
Those guys.
I don't think so. I think it's just a hodgepodge of, like, third parties and whatnot.
Oh, indie developers, I'm guessing.
It's maybe. Not even, like, Valve. Like, I don't think Valve's even gonna...
No, Valve should just do that. Valve, PC Gamer, team up and do the PC Gaming Show at E3. That would be fine, you know?
Yeah.
Because they are, like, the heads of gaming almost on PC.
But, yeah, they're... It'll be interesting. That the PC gaming is just, that's something completely new and it hasn't been done so like other than this year. So.
I feel like if they show anything, it'll be like maybe technology. Maybe Nvidia games. Will be there.
Yeah, they'll probably show some new graphics cards maybe, but I mean they're gonna show games. It's called the PC gaming show.
Yes.
well,
maybe that's when we'll see like I don't know. Never mind. No, I was thinking like.
Or are you gonna say Half-Life 3?
No, well, maybe, but I was thinking like maybe Telltale would be there or something, but I forgot that like they can.
Telltale's gonna be everywhere.
Yeah, it can be everywhere.
They're gonna be everywhere. They're gonna be like spread across everything.
I'm pretty sure they started on PC, so I mean, you know.
I guess so.
You never know.
That show is at 8 Eastern, 8 p.m. at night. Eastern and
5 Pacific time.
Yeah, 7 for Central. And it is that the PC Gaming Show is going to conclude E3, and that happens on Tuesday. So it goes Sunday night through Tuesday night, and then it is all done. I have to do stuff on the 17th and the 18th, so I might not be able to record a podcast like the 17th. But if we can get it up super early, like, you know, as soon as I can record it and put it up after the show's end, which might be like Friday or something. If we can do that, we probably will. But if not, we might just do, we might just upload it at our regular time, which is on Monday. What are you waving?
What?
What are you waving? All right then. Nice. It's like waving a measuring tape across the screen.
Yeah.
But yeah, so let's go over our E3 predictions, right, and then let's we'll talk just go about
top to bottom.
I guess so. But then let's talk about what we. I don't know. Let's just throw out some hypothetical questions. Talk about what we want to see, who we think will be there. Blah blah blah.
Well, I feel like it would be cool just go through the conferences and do that. And if there's any extras, we can go over them after.
Sure.
Because some of my things I want to say are within this list. So.
All right. I'll say one, and then you can say one.
Okay.
Bethesda, these are,
Greg method.
These are our E3 predictions. And some of these, we put these out like 2 months ago, to be honest. Like a long time ago.
I need a whiteboard.
Oh my gosh. we put these out like 2 months ago, I'm pretty sure. And some of them have already come to fruition.
But, oh my gosh.
But we'll discuss how the points work and whatnot. When we get to it.
I do have a note. All right.
Like which is this first one. My first prediction was Bethesda will announce a new IP at their E3 conference and Fallout 4. So, I don't think I should get a point for Fallout 4.
Well, if you're doing the whole points.
Because I said announce. You know what I mean?
At E3, you know.
These are all specifically worded.
At
in E3. A way. I said that they would announce it at E3. So, if they announce a new IP, I'll get half a point. We should totally do halves and whatnot. I think that makes sense.
Are you writing this down?
I mean, it's all on the Google Doc.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's right.
I don't have a notepad or anything.
I do. I was writing down something else to remind myself.
Yeah, half points. All right, what's your first one? See, you cheated the system with this.
I don't even remember what I put. Let me look at this.
Are you not on the dock?
No,
I read it.
Hold on, I got this. what, Battlefront?
Yeah, the way you worded it.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, okay. I made it seem like because I knew that they were gonna show it at the April thing, the showing or whatever. The festival. The Star Wars festival or whatever.
Star Wars Celebration.
So Star Wars Celebration. That's right. I knew they were going to do that, so I changed it like a cheeky person I am. Gosh.
Did you change it? Oh, you did change it. That is cheap.
Before they showed the trailer, I said they were going to show a trailer and gameplay at E3, but I changed it to Battlefront gameplay from EA at DICE at E3. Now at the Star Wars Celebration, we got a trailer. So. It's still a valid point.
But see,
and
it
will happen.
So. Yeah, there will be gameplay, and Eric will get a freaking guaranteed point. Gosh dang it. My next one is I said that there will be a release date for Persona 5, but I wasn't ballsy enough to say Western release date. I said Japanese.
Yeah, that's probably.
I bet that's gonna. I feel like that's a safe one.
I feel good about that one, too. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know. This next one from Eric, I feel like, is a tiny bit ballsy, to be totally honest.
Yeah. I would change it, but I'm going to...
No, you can't. You can't change it now.
I'm not.
These are all set in stone. So what... What is it?
We might get a release date for No Man's Sky. I believe...
Yeah, he wrote might. No Man's Sky release date.
Okay. I thought I had... I didn't read it right. I thought I had said something about it being released this year, but I feel like we will get
It's possible.
Order 1, 2016 release date.
Yeah, but if it's not an exact release date, I don't know if it counts. I feel like release date should be exact.
I want to use it for I want to use an umbrella term here because I don't know, and that way I can still get a point if it does happen.
Now, release date I think should be exact, but if you get like if it's like a quarter or whatever, you can get like half or something. Yeah, it's still partially release date, but it's not an exact release date.
Quarter 1, 2016. There, I'll even write it down.
Okay. So now you're changing it completely, and you're going to say No Man's Sky release date. You're saying that they are going to say quarter 1, 2016.
This is what I think it will be. Quarter 1, 2016.
That's your prediction, bro.
Yes.
All right, then. See, I ain't making any alterations. Like, I'm just sticking with my balls. All right. And then
I should probably just stay with the blanket statement. Okay.
So right. if you get a quarterly one, though, it's a half point. And if you get an exact one, it's a full point. Gentleman's agreement.
What do you mean?
Kids across the internet. I feel like you should not get a full point if you do not get an exact release date.
I'm just saying if they do say something about a release date there, then I get a point. I don't feel like the game's even ready to be.
No, I don't know.
Release date. So I can still lose a point here.
Yeah, no, but so, I'm just saying release date as a term means the date, not the not the release area of the calendar.
Okay.
Yeah,
yeah, I know what you're saying.
Yeah, I'm just
saying like it will get a release window type of thing. That's why I'm trying to.
Well then,
maybe I should reword.
Type window, release window. Yeah, that's a good term for it too. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. My next one was I say that Guerrilla Games is going to announce their new IP.
What else did they make? I don't follow. Killzone. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Sure. They.
Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like that's a safe bet. People who are listening. Guerrilla Games created a Twitter account for the first time like a day or two ago, so that's a pretty telling sign.
Yeah.
For the first time, so.
Hmm.
Yeah, I feel like that one's gonna happen. I hope so too because the concept art for that looks freaking great. So.
Yeah.
Man.
I've already won this one, so. There's 2 points for me.
He wrote Destiny Big Expansion, Cinematic Trailer, and News. So, that's almost confirmed already. You went with some You went with some pretty safe bets here.
It's true. And
those
guess
two
what?
Are
I think
super
my
safe.
Last one's going to work out, too.
Ooh, Q4 2016?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh, that's pretty good, too, yeah. These are all super safe. I liked it better when your No Man's Sky was release date instead of window.
I don't know.
That one was better for me. Oh, well. Might as well say it. Your last one is Dark Souls 3
Dark
will
Souls
be announced 3. For Q4 2016.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Gosh, dang it. So I said,
I really like that.
See,
prediction.
I went, oh, I lost a point already because I went ballsy like a real man. And I said during the Sony press conference, they will announce an HD remastered Uncharted trilogy for the PS4. Which has happened. Maybe it was going to be at the press conference, but
maybe
it got leaked.
Maybe we can give you some leeway on that one.
Okay. Maybe I should just get a half point for that one.
Or maybe you should just exchange a new prediction. Completely.
Yeah.
Because that one was kind of just leaked. I feel like they were going to show that at
E3. Yeah, maybe I should exchange one for that.
Go ahead and exchange it. I'm okay with
that. But you should also exchange one of your guarantees.
Okay, I'll just...
like your Battlefront or your Destiny one.
I had a really good one, too. Oh, yes. This is really ballsy, but I'll go with
a ballsy one, too. You're going to. I just thought of one that's like super risky. I don't. You're typing this already, and I'm like, I don't know what to think of this at all.
There was something else about it that I was gonna say.
Yes. He wrote Nintendo goes third party and... and makes an interesting new IP. Well, they kind of did already with Splatoon.
With Splatoon,
but
yes.
They might do more. But what do you mean by goes third party? As in, like, has third party support? More of it? As in, like, maybe in their Nintendo Direct, they're like, hey, we're going to bring in some more third parties. Blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, and actually make games that are focused with the controller, not just their freaking Wii remotes, you know?
Yeah. So mine is...
make it more accessible.
Mine is ridiculously ballsy. I don't think this is going to happen. You know, I kind of got to think of a different one because I honestly don't think this is going to be a thing. I was going to say they announced an infamous Cole McGrath collection. But if they
Sucker
did
Punch
that...
Sucker Punch has been kind of quiet. I mean...
This was one of the questions we were going to discuss. I was going to say, what do you think we're going to hear from Sucker Punch at the press conference? But if we are even going to hear from them. I'm gonna do one related to them. It's
maybe
not going to be that. Hold on.
They come out with a new IP.
I'm going to type in... Sucker Punch announces that they are doing something away from Infamous.
Yeah.
So that they're moving away from Infamous and doing something new. Which I don't want them to do, but I feel like that's what they're going to do.
I do feel the same way. Like, even though Second Son was, like, amazing and so was First Light, I feel like there's not... too much to go on off
in
of,
the way they did the universe. They were basically like, there's not much else to do.
Yeah, it's true. But I mean, hey,
they did that with freaking Infamous 2, and then they came back. So
yes, this is true.
All the conduits were dead in Infamous 2, by the way.
Yeah,
don't fully understand how they're alive again, but you know, makes
this alternate universe Flash, man. Speed Force. It's a Speed Force. Maybe there's this, like, seriously, what if, like, Cole McGrath made a freaking, you know, wormhole, and just, there's an alternate.
Maybe that's what the lightning bolt at the end.
Maybe.
Do you know about
fiction,
that, by the way? Spoilers for Infamous
you
2.
You showed me.
Yeah, the freaking lightning bolt that looks like a 3. That was the worst.
Oh.
Why would they do that? Why would they do that to my heart? Anyways, so were you going to change out one of your safe ones for that one, or were you going
to... No, I was just going to add on to it. I don't want to forget those.
You can't have 6 and me have 5. Or you have 5 and me have 4, actually. I mean, I can try and
move
add
them
one,
around.
But I just... your 2 are so safe. What are you...
I'm just moving them around. I want them to still be there. I'll separate them. There.
That doesn't help at all, but that doesn't help with the fact that you have 5 and I have 4 now. That's what I'm saying.
Now I have 3.
No, you still have 5 though. Those are confirmed. Like they're still your predictions though, and you have the possibility of getting 5 points. I have the possibility of getting 4 points. Do you understand? I have 4 predictions, which means
yes.
I can only get 4. You have 5, which means you can get 5. So you either need to take away one.
Get another one.
You either need to take away one of your confirmed.
I want
to
add another one.
Yeah, but I took away a confirmed. My Uncharted one was basically like, it's already done. It's already happened. I would have gotten a point from it.
So what do you want me to do?
Take away one of your confirmed.
Why?
Because I took away one of mine that I would have gotten a point for.
I'll just take away the obvious one. Actually, they're both obvious. What the
heck? Yeah, that's what I was saying. Just one of them. Just one of them. And then we can both add another, because why not?
Okay.
Let me...
What if I add one that will probably end up me losing points?
Oh, you're going to add a risky one?
No, I'm going to get... I'm going to I'm going
just,
to lose a point
delete...
for typing this on my screen, okay?
My gosh. But that means I have to add 2 more.
Yes.
Do you get
and
that?
You win.
But I don't have 2 more. I don't have 2 more. I only have 1 more in my brain.
Fine.
So, like, delete one, and then we'll add one together.
Okay. I'll get rid of the Destiny one.
I think you said that you had one, and you
and
had
then
one rolling around. All right. Eric is adding his fifth and final prediction. I should think of a Microsoft one. He wrote with Fallout 4 coming out and developers being. Oh my gosh! He's adding a ridiculous thing that is not gonna happen. He wrote with Fallout 4 coming out and developers being ballsy, Half-Life 3 is poked, he said.
Not even teased. Poked.
Gosh dang it. Well, I was actually gonna add a legit pretty.
Damn.
Shots fired.
I told you, I'm gonna lose a point for this
right.
one.
Dang, bro.
So, there you go.
I'm gonna do one about either Microsoft or Nintendo. Ooh, I could do a Ubisoft one. I should do one about Assassin's Creed.
Oh, yeah. That's a good idea.
Ooh.
Oh,
Watch
Dogs 2.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna do. That's what I was thinking. That's immediately what I went to.
I feel like they can correct any mistakes that people didn't like.
Are they gonna announce it though and be like next year or
Q3 next year?
Q3, that's not normal.
Or actually,
I like that though.
Actually, when did the first one come out?
Yeah.
Was it last year?
Yeah, it was last year. Really? It was delayed into the next year.
You think they'll make it a yearly release?
No, I hope not. God, I hope not. We'll do that. Stop it. Stop it.
Yeah,
stop with
Colin
the annual
said
releases.
They would. So
stop it. They already have one going though. Like they already have Assassin's Creed annual, which is like so many studios around the world working on it. They would have to get so many more to make it annual. And I don't think people want that. Nobody wants that. They would get backlash.
You would just get oversaturated with.
They would get hardcore backlash.
Open world games, you know.
Man, I was thinking about this earlier. There are so many open world games and games
it's
that
true.
Are huge. That's why I like Uncharted so much. It's linear. You play it and you're done.
That's just...
There's so yeah, like why are there so many games that are just like here,
I mean,
we want this game to
great.
Take over your life.
But
I don't have enough time.
Sometimes I just want like a 20-hour game, you know?
Oh, man. That's why I love Infamous games so much. Because it's all doable.
They're, like
they're all a cool
linear.
Story, and you can platinum it in like 20 hours, and it's great. And then you're done, and you can move on. Whereas most games, you think you can freaking do that with Witcher in 20 hours and move on? No, you're sucked into that for 200 hours. Stop it.
Yeah.
Stop it.
Though Witcher is still a good game.
I mean,
so
they're
is
great.
Skyrim
I
and,
just
you know,
don't.
Stuff, but.
I just want.
I like
less
how we're saying this.
That.
We play MMOs all the time.
Yeah, I know.
But
that's
still,
the problem.
I mean,
that's the problem is that I want less of those because they're everywhere and they're huge, and I already have so many. And I already can't complete all the games that I have. Yeah, like just give me something. Give me shorter games, please.
Yeah, just story-driven narratives.
I mean, don't stop with the huge games. Just give me more of the shorter ones. And maybe lessen up with the huge ones a little bit. Like, come on, 200 hours is a little much, Witcher. Okay, so I'm gonna type in. I feel like they're gonna announce Watch Dogs 2, and then not say much about it. Like, there's not gonna be like, oh, it's releasing here. Maybe they'll talk more about it later. They're gonna be like, we're working on it. We know it's I'm gonna
Same.
Be like Watch Dogs 2 announced, and then this is ballsy, but no release date. If there's a release window, I get a half point. See what I mean? Because release window is different from date.
Yeah.
So they could do a release window, but I don't think they're gonna give an exact date.
Right.
All right. There we go. Me and Eric both have 5 E3 predictions that we can go over on our post E3 show. This is probably going to, I'm just going to say it, most likely going to be up next Monday.
As much as right now, I don't feel like there's going to be any surprises.
Oh, there's totally going to be
but
surprises.
But there with, I feel like with Fallout 4 being announced that developers might, I honestly feel like, I feel like Half 3 is a little long stretch, but I feel like some developers will be a little bit more ballsy or maybe even more reserved because of Fallout, and they might even delay.
That's what Colin was saying. He was like, people need to get out of there. Right, nothing's gonna be
Fallout is gonna like trample on everything else's sales.
Yeah,
but they can games like Battlefront will still have a chance, probably still get their same. Huge, they'll obviously still get the same amount that they would have with Fallout in the window. But
yeah, so, there's totally gonna be surprises. There are surprises every E3. The Sony press conference is full of games that are like, here's all these new games that you had no idea that were happening, and they're coming out, or blah, blah, blah. Sony has so many first-party studios that we don't know what they're working on.
Yeah.
Like Media Molecule, nobody knows what's going on over there. Housemarque is doing that Alien Nation, but we don't know when it's coming.
Right.
There's a lot more first-party studios that I'm just blanking on right now that just... Yeah. haven't said anything. Like, I was listening to Beyond. Like, they said this. They were talking about... At the first E3 for PlayStation 4, there was, like, a sizzle reel that was, like, all these developers are working on PS4 games, and it just flashed, like, all the first-party studios, and half of them haven't said anything about what they're working on. And that was, like, 2 years ago. So there are things happening that we just don't know about. There are so many surprises.
I feel like there are surprises. I just feel like they're not obvious. That's what I was kind of getting at. So, yeah.
Well, heck yeah. It wouldn't be a surprise if it wasn't obvious.
Not as in, like, obvious. Oh, yeah, definitely. That's going to come out. It's just nothing. There's nothing there. So, usually, I mean, hey, a lot of people were saying that, Fallout 4 will come out. And if it were to be announced at E3, that would be a giant surprise. I mean, obviously, it's already out. And it was a surprise, so.
I sort of see what you mean.
Yeah.
I sort of see what you mean. There's still going to be tons of surprises.
I feel like we're not going to see anything that we thought. Like, I feel like we're going to get a surprise that we never even, like, thought of, maybe.
We will. We do every E3 that happens. Every E3 there's something crazy. So, I don't know. Let's highlight. What are you most excited about? And then we should go through the press conferences real quick. And then be like. But what are you most excited about? The Sony conference? Because that's what I'm
excited about. I don't know.
Out of doubt. Sony press conference is so good every year. It's so good.
Probably Bethesda and Microsoft, because I feel like I know what I'm getting at Sony.
But Eric, you don't. Last year, there were so many games that was like, here's this, you've never heard of this, here's this, you've never heard of this. All of these are new. Like, there's like a... And then there's always like a sizzle reel of new indie games
that no one's ever heard of. I know that, but... For the stuff I do know, it's good. I know what I'm going to get. I know what's going to happen. I know we're going to get new stuff, and it's going to be awesome. But I know what's going to be shown, definitely, at Bethesda and Microsoft's, which is going to be Fallout 4 gameplay. And actually, the first three, Bethesda, Microsoft, and EA, they're going to have, all in a row, Fallout 4, and then Halo 5, and then Battlefront. Those are three games I'm really looking forward to, and they're right in a row.
Yeah,
there's nothing like giant besides Uncharted 4, obviously.
Uncharted 4, the Uncharted collection, anything Sony does, the new Guerrilla IP, which is I bet that's a thing that's gonna happen this year. It's been too long. There's been rumors about The Last Guardian showing up at E3.
Yes, this is
like
true.
Freaking. I'm telling you, dude. I'm telling you.
Why didn't one of us do that prediction? Honestly, I feel like it would happen.
Everyone does. Everyone does. Why not keep it simple? I don't know.
Yeah.
I I don't know, man. Last Guardian's been talked about for 7 years or whatever.
It's true.
Like,
I've watched the game, and it's really cool. It's a different type of game, and it's really...
I bet you money...
You don't see many games like it, so...
Is it what they originally announced? Is that what you watched, like the little gameplay trailer or whatever?
No, I was talking about the game, the second game. I'm pretty sure The Last Guardian is the third game in the series.
I do not think that's a thing at all.
I'm talking about the other two games.
No, that's what I'm saying. I don't think that's true at all. The Last Guardian's a new IP, completely.
Yes, I know. No, wait. Okay. No, it's not.
Almost positive.
They have different names. Each game has different names. Instead of calling Uncharted 1, 2, and 3, take out the word Uncharted and just have the subtitle.
Yeah. There.
That's pretty much what they do. It's weird, but they don't put numbers. It's not the same game. They all have different stories. It's kind of like... you've probably heard me talk about...
Are you saying Shadow of the Colossus is in the same series? Because that's not true at all. Okay.
But they're obviously by the same people.
Yeah, they're just by the same developers.
I feel like it's in the same realm of... I don't know.
I don't think so. Let's read the Wikipedia page.
Giant colossuses that you're taking down.
That's not confirmed for The Last Guardian at all. It might be a completely different game. No one knows anything about The Last Guardian. That's what's crazy. It's been being worked on for 7 years.
It could be a spin-off of Destiny.
Oh my gosh. The Last Guardian and Destiny.
And everyone rages.
That's what it finally is. Bungie, has been working with them forever. Oh my gosh.
No.
What nightmare that would be.
I think that would... People would rage. People would leave E3 right there.
Let's see.
But yeah, Last Guardian, that...
The game has been shown to involve a young boy who befriends a giant bird/cat-like creature, and the two work together to evade guards that are after them both. That looks like, so far, all that we've... The game has been in development since 2007. It was formally announced at the 2009 E3 with a planned release in 2011, expected for the PS3 console. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like,
oh my
gosh. They...
See, I bet they got the PS4 hardware and we're like, maybe we should.
It's just that, like, this thing has been in development for so long. Like, it could have just changed courses a ton.
And they've successfully turned it into a Half-Life 3.
Yeah, I don't know, man. It's gonna be interesting if they do show it off, because it's similar to Half-Life, as in people have been waiting for this game for like 7 years.
Yeah,
that's
true.
So Bethesda, they're gonna show off Fallout 4 for sure. They're gonna
show off a new IP.
They're gonna show off Doom.
Doom 4, obviously, dude.
Show off any Quake? Maybe.
I don't know. Quake hasn't really been in the spotlight for a while, so I don't know. Unless I'm missing out on something.
Has
Quake been a thing recently or something?
Neither has Doom.
Well, no, Doom, but Doom's a series. It's like
so a thing. Quake.
I don't know. Quake has been more of a arena shooter type of thing. So.
Exactly. Imagine them... ramping that up and bringing it to current gen. That'd be crazy.
Yeah.
Be crazy. I don't know. Most of Bethesda's conference is a mystery. Yeah, Dishonored 2 is most likely.
I feel like they could do it. Because
they could,
Dishonored
1,
you have Dishonored, right?
Yeah.
You got it for free or something on PS3. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you need to play it because the mechanics are like I haven't seen in any other game ever. And it's really cool. So
I don't know. Yeah, Bethesda's conference is mostly a mystery. So
We might see some Wolfenstein stuff. That would be cool.
Yeah, maybe because
speaking of Wolfenstein, I'm gonna buy that right after this.
Oh snap!
On PC.
Oh snap! Steam summer sale. It's getting all
of us. $10.
It's getting all of us. Dang.
Yeah.
Microsoft conference. They are definitely gonna show off Halo 5.
Oh, Halo 5 is gonna be like
show off
Forza. The lights go off for the Bethesda conference. They come back. You hear the Halo music. Bam.
The The lights and go off for the like, Bethesda conference is the night before.
I know. I'm saying like it,
the Bethesda, I'm imagining the, that as like an goes, instant transition. Just time lapse. My goodness. That's some advanced crap.
Yeah.
But Halo 5, I bet you money they're gonna open their conference with.
Yes. They'll have the dude. And, you know, and then Halo 5 and yeah.
There have been rumors going around that Microsoft has lost their exclusivity with Call of Duty. So, again, imagine if the Sony conference opens with a gosh dang Call of Duty trailer. Everyone would lose their freaking minds. Or at least people that know what that is and how that works. Everyone would lose their minds. I would lose it. That's crazy. That's a crazy thing. It's been Call of Duty and Microsoft since Call of Duty started.
Yes. See, I feel that kind of, but I don't know. I feel like this time, for some reason, I feel like they're just cut the exclusivity completely. I don't know why.
That would be interesting if they did that.
They just kind of stop exclusives.
I would like that, but
they would be. I doubt it, but
yeah.
I don't know.
They gotta show up at one conference. There's no Activision conference. So yeah, Microsoft, Forza, bunch of new stuff. We're not too tuned into that, so we don't fully know much.
But what?
Well, I'm definitely gonna watch it. Like freaking heck yeah, dude.
What?
Microsoft.
Microsoft. Yeah. I can't really think of anything else at Microsoft, honestly.
That's why I just said we're not tuned into that. We don't know too much, so we'll wait and see. We're definitely going to watch it, you know.
I feel like we're going to see some stuff about a Halo TV show first. I just have a feeling.
Didn't that already happen?
Yeah, there was Nightfall, but apparently it sucked.
Dang,
but
shots fired. Bing, bing, bing.
I've seen the first episode and it was pretty good, so I don't know myself, but I feel like we'll see something more. I don't know.
Okay.
Maybe we're gonna see a book. Obviously, they're coming out with a book soon for Halo. So.
Yeah, we'll see tons of stuff that we don't know about. I'm sure you Xbox people know about it.
EA.
Oh, they're totally gonna show off Smite stuff. That's gonna happen.
Smite.
So, that's gonna happen.
Probably just quick trailer, be like, yeah, Smite, and then move on.
Yeah, it could be one of those things where they're like, oh, this many people played Smite on our console. Blah, blah. And then, like, celebratory.
Yeah.
Moving on. I bet that's going to be similar to what Bungie does. Bungie's going to come out and be like, you all played this game, blah, blah, blah. So EA, they're going to show off some of them racing stuff, but mostly they're going to show off Battlefront. And that's basically it. From what I know.
Wait, if it goes by EA's track record, they'll probably show the best for last, which would be Battlefront, obviously.
Yeah. EA has a lot of stuff. Will they show off any Mass Effect 4 crap? Because that's rumored.
No, it's not rumored. It's confirmed, obviously, but rumored at E3? It's
not confirmed.
Confirmed as it's like it's a thing.
I know, that's what I'm saying. I don't think so.
What?
Oh, well, they're confirmed that... I'm pretty sure that it's confirmed that they're working on a new Mass Effect.
Yes. But
I don't
At
know.
At E3? I don't know. We don't know.
I don't know if it's going to be Mass Effect 4.
I feel like...
Is it going to be like Mass Effect colon something else. And be a completely new place?
It's 4. I thought from what I heard that they already showed concept art. So...
Interesting.
I feel like... If anything, we'll have a teaser. A CGI teaser.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know, man. They've been quiet about that for a long time. What if they were just like Mass Effect 4 and it's coming out this fall? Like, the last Mass Effect 3 was a long time ago, to be honest.
Actually, I kind of doubt it.
It's possible, though.
Main reason, because being Fallout 4.
Yeah, they might not want to go up against it. But at the same time, dude, people plan this in forever. They don't like people thought that you know that year, you know, the year where Sony came out and trounced Microsoft, people were like, oh, they totally changed the price point because they heard of Microsoft. Like, that's a huge financial business decision that affects millions of companies and people who invested in Sony. Like, they can't physically do that. And, like, if they heard Fallout 4, like, I mean, it gives them a couple of weeks, but they most likely, if it is this fall, you know, they most likely had it planned for, like, a long time. They were like, okay, we're going to announce it at this C3. It's going to come out here. So they most likely... wouldn't care, but if they do care, maybe they'll announce it and then
obviously we're probably gonna see, you know, FIFA 2015.
Oh yeah, FIFA, you're gonna see your sports stuff, your Maddens and whatnot.
Yeah,
Ubisoft, and see lots of that Ubisoft. Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
Syndicate, we'll see, probably see some full gameplay.
Maybe you'll see people that are be like, we're working on the next Far Cry. The next Far Cry is super far off, but maybe they'll be like, we're working on it. We got an idea. Because, you know, similar to the Battlefront thing that they did last year that was like, we love Star Wars.
Oh, yeah. By the way, back to E3 for a second.
EA.
EA, sorry. What did I say, E3?
Oh. Yeah. Like, back to E3. Because we stopped
back
talking.
Back to EA for a second. I feel like... we might hear something about Battlefield's future.
Yeah,
I don't
maybe
know.
They'll talk about it, but it won't be like anytime
soon. I feel like, I mean, Visceral was that was their own game. It wasn't. It had nothing to do with DICE besides the multiplayer engine.
Yeah.
And that was pretty much it. So yeah. DICE has something in the works, I'm assuming.
Yeah,
or maybe they're taking a break. And
I feel like that sounds about right. Maybe they'll just discuss Battlefield's future. You know, that sounds good.
Yeah.
So Ubisoft is totally going to show off, like,
Syndicate
their
gameplay.
Syndicate, Watch Dogs 2.
Prince of Persia, please. I would pre-order that in a freaking heartbeat.
Did you? Let's see. They're totally going to show off, you know, some of their artsy stuff, like Child of Light that they've been doing. Valiant Hearts, stuff like that. They're going to show off, I bet, new ideas similar to those. New stories. Yeah, Ubisoft is going to be good. You're going to see your Just Dances and whatnot.
Yeah.
I'm excited for that. And Sony, you're gonna kick it off with Call of Duty? No, I'm just kidding. but you're totally going to see some in-game Uncharted collection. You're going to see a little bit more of Uncharted 4. Not much, but a little bit. Maybe just an extra trailer.
You know what a good way to start off the Sony conference would be?
Yeah.
Something new.
Just Dance. Sorry.
No.
just a bunch of people dancing.
If Guerrilla Games does have something.
Yeah, start it off with that.
Start out with that.
That'd be
something
cool.
New.
I would like that.
And then right
end
into
it.
Uncharted
4. I don't know. I kind of... oh, man. I don't know. Any way they do it, it's going to be fine.
Yeah.
There's going to be Metal Gear. Metal Gear is going to be big.
Metal Gear gameplay.
It's going to be huge. People are super pumped for that game. I almost mixed stoked and pumped. People are super poked. Super poked. But yeah, a lot of people are excited for Metal Gear. Let's see here.
Nintendo announces amiibos for Splatoon.
Wait, amiibos for Splatoon are already a thing, by the way.
Oh my gosh, dang.
Yeah. I just thought of that. I was like, wait a minute.
Are you serious?
Yeah. There's some squid amiibos hanging out. Oh, man. Nintendo's going to be interesting. You know, they're totally going to focus on Star Fox a lot.
They announced Star Fox amiibos of their own console. There you go.
Oh, my God.
Gold and silver.
That's super meta.
Yeah. No, they're amiibos of amiibos.
Oh, my God. That is insane.
It just had, like, it's an amiibo of the amiibo stand. There you go.
Amiiboception, dude. Holy crap. But Nintendo, they're going to focus on Star Fox. They said that they are not bringing Zelda to E3. But some people are like, what if they're lying? Which is possible, but I doubt it. They're like Zelda's not going to be at E3. Don't get your hopes up. So that's interesting. But
yeah, Zelda's a big game. This one at least looks really big. So... be great.
Oh gosh.
Cool.
Yeah, Zelda's huge.
Zelda on PS4.
It's not gonna happen. Literally, that is like a joke.
But hey, it would be cool because that
it would be cool, would but
be able to play it easier.
It would be cool, but that is never going to happen ever.
That's why I'm like, what if they just make their games not exclusive?
Nintendo will never do that unless they are dying economically. I mean, unless like that is their last option.
Besides Amiibos, actually.
Unless that is their last option.
The only thing that's keeping them alive is 3DS and Amiibos. I'm going to say that right now.
Wii is still generating profit, I'm sure.
It's not as good as the Wii did, though.
The Wii was the best-selling console all time, I'm almost positive. Almost positive.
Sure, yeah.
So, yeah, that's not going to do as well as the Wii. But in general, even compared to other consoles, it's not doing well. But it's still not, like, you know, dry. They're not hobos yet.
Yes.
They're not hobos yet. So. Square Enix, gonna see some of that Tomb Raider. It's going to be spread across Microsoft and Square Enix conference. You're going to see...
Is that still exclusive?
Is Final Fantasy 15?
Is Tomb Raider still exclusive to Xbox?
Yes.
Is it timed?
Yes. How are you so out of the loop?
I remember hearing something about it being timed, and then I was making sure. Okay. So
It's always been a timed exclusive for Xbox.
Okay.
And it has not changed yet.
Why they would do that? No one knows, but
okay. For money.
Oh, dude, I didn't even think about it. Back up to Microsoft. Gears of War.
Yep, they're gonna show a Gears 4 teaser a bit.
Yeah,
because they're working on that. That'll be awesome. That's the thing. So, yeah, I bet there's gonna be a teaser. So, Not much more. Just a little like
here. Back down to
The PC gaming show.
Yeah, the PC gaming show.
That is, I don't even want to like predict anything because that's like totally new. Yeah, they're gonna show off some Nvidia cards maybe. Then that's all I got.
I feel like we'll see some stuff from Nvidia. Nvidia will host a little segment and say, "Hey, we're having a new card, and also here's some featured games that we're sponsoring." Blah blah blah, and this is a new thing. And they're going to show, like, what's going to happen at the PC gaming show. So, I don't know. We'll have to see.
Are you saying they're going to, like, introduce it?
Sure.
All right. Sure. Why not? YOLO. But, yeah, it's, I don't know. Everything else is going to be a surprise. I bet NVIDIA is going to be there for, like, a second. I don't think they're going to be there as long as that. But they're going to be there. They're going to say something, and then they're going to leave. And then it's all surprises from there.
They should just leave with their, like, jingle.
NVIDIA! Well, that is what you can expect from E3, from some two slightly educated people on this subject matter.
Yeah, and slightly. Before we head off, I wrote down some notes here. If you want to watch E3 and hear some news or thoughts on other people's opinions, obviously, you can watch it on Twitch, and I'm assuming there'll be a website where it is hosted on the E3 website.
Probably.
You can also watch it on IGN and a bunch of other gaming media.
IGN's going to have a pre-show and post-show for each conference.
Our friends over, best friends over at Kind of Funny, they're doing a post or pre and post shows.
I'm pretty sure that they're just going to be going like almost the whole time. Yep. Like even when a conference isn't about to begin, they're still going to be like,
oh, they're hosting. They're going to host E3.
Yeah, they're but what I mean is like even when in the downtime, they're just going to be like talking about stuff.
They'll be tweeting or something. Or we'll see.
No, I mean, they're going to be... What I'm saying is that they're going to be live almost the whole time when conferences aren't going on. They're going to be doing what they did at Gamescom, which is basically just, like, talking about it and whatnot.
Yeah.
So definitely tune into that. Let us know your favorite announcement next week in the comments section, because it hasn't happened yet.
Yeah.
So I am very, very excited about this. We're going to see Destiny stuff. We're going to see freaking Black Ops 3 stuff. We're going to see some zombies for Black Ops 3. It's going to be cool.
I'm going to say this ahead ahead of time. I apologize for my actions in the next video on this channel, because I'm going to be freaking out probably.
Where you're just like, ah!
Yeah.
Foaming at the mouth, guy. We're going to both.
Stop, future self, stop.
Oh my gosh. Dude, what we should do is we should start the show off with the foaming mouth guy clip. And then go in. Yes. That would be great.
I can edit that in.
That'd be great. So we will talk to you next week. Do we want to, I mean, Eric, we wanted to do this super short. It's been an hour and 10 minutes.
Yeah.
So this is basically a regular
let's
show,
just
but the
call
E3 pre-show.
Number 29.
Nah. Now, I might put a number on it. Might not. I'll probably just call it the pre-show. So,
yeah,
there we go. Do we want to show a random object though, as of tradition?
Yeah,
freaking why
obviously
not? You know, just
oh dang it, I was about to I picked something and then I already showed it.
Oh, we're getting
no,
close.
I didn't pick it, it didn't happen though. I just looked over and it was like
it almost happened.
I
can do it if you don't want to. I got
one. You go ahead.
Okay. Control freaks help you improve your aim in FPSs.
Control freaks.
There right. you go. Here, that's right, it.
Here you go. I got.
Oh, here's Eric.
All right. I have like 20 receipts to Subway. There you go.
Oh my gosh. Why do you still have those?
Because I give
unless
them to my
the
mom.
The IRS comes after you.
Yeah. And they're all meatball marinara.
Dude, I keep going to Subway and being like, I really need to try something new, and I
Dude,
get the same freaking thing.
I'm gonna write this down for you.
I don't like. I'm not a big fan of meatball marinara sandwiches.
Have you even had it?
Oh.
Dang. Damn it! You can't say a dang word.
Dang it. Oh well. Well, we will talk to you guys after E3.